So let me tell you a story about how a miserable evening turned around and delivered two of my favorite photos of 2018. After a long day, which actually started out with the two locations from the previous video from the Faroes, we ended up on the northernmost island of the Faroes, Vidoy. I had done my homework and had a strong vision for a couple of beautiful sunset photos from this island. However, as for the weather, it just would not cooperate despite an optimistic forecast. I also had an intent of making this video, and because of our schedule, plans and limited time, I just had to accept the weather I got. We started out on the eastern side of the island, but because of a complete brain fart and miscalculation from my side, we managed to scratch our rental car when parking it. And yeah, we did have the insurance, but we had to pay the excess. While there, dodging the continuing showers, I did manage to fly my drone to get the photo, however without the sunset I had envisioned. Even though I did not get my sunset, it turned out to not be as bad as I thought on location. You see, waterfalls in the Faroes empty out very fast after just as little as a day without rain. Because of all these showers kept soaking the earth and filling the streams, there were quite a lot of waterfalls along the coastline, which in hindsight worked perfect for the photo, and I probably would not have got on a day with a sunset. Being tired after a long day, disappointed about the weather and conditions, scratching the car and having to look forward to paying the excess, my mood for photography was at an absolute low point, to say the least. With a bit back and forth with Sophie, we decided to call it a day and drive back to our accommodation. But on the road, just leaving the island, I did remember that when you have feelings like these, it is just feelings, and over time of course they will pass. Now I didn't want I decided not to listen to these feelings, because in the end, if I didn't get anything from there, they would have won and it would have been a complete failure. So I actually ended up deciding that we headed back to where I initially wanted to go. We turned the car around and drove back through the tunnel from where we came and towards the settlement or the northern part of the island. I aimed for the hike up the northern mountain of Vidoy, which is easy to find as you just have to find the northernmost road of the island. This hike might cost money in the future, so be aware of that. So, it is now 10 p.m. and we're in the Faroe Islands, and it's almost summer solstice, which means there's still 1 hour and 30 minutes-ish to sunset, and then the sun will rise again, 3:30. But we are at an island, or on an island, called Vidoy, and we are in a settlement called Vidaraidi or something like that. And the point here is to climb this mountain here, not all the way up, just a little bit, to photograph the settlement down here and have this mountain as a background. Over here, this one, we have the northern tip of Bordoy, another island. And I think I will make a panorama or something like that. And use the mist or the rain to separate the things. I don't know. I'm not entirely sure. I have an idea about what I want. We did hope that it would clear, but that is always an optimistic wish for the Faroe Islands. So you gotta work with what nature gives you. And this is not too shabby. Very moody. Just as I like it. You simply just follow the path along the stone fence and then the blue poles after the gate along the trail up the mountain. Just before it becomes all stony, you turn left and keep hiking until you reach the ditches. So we have found this beautiful little stream here, but it doesn't really add much to the picture. But look at this background here. This is just amazing. And then of course, place a person down here to get a good separation and then just F11 fire off. The good thing about this place is we actually also get a bit of the background over here, the water over here. So we really get the background mountain here isolated too. And it really makes the entire thing pop and stand out. So I will just find the perfect composition right here and take some shots. So this place is just absolutely fantastic. It's so ominous and we managed to like get some really dark and like almost threatening scenes, like very adventurous and dramatic at once. Rain keeps coming in, hammering us, and that's just the conditions. Like if there was no rain, we would probably not get as a dramatic mood either. Overall, this place is just super cool, super super cool. So what I initially intended for this photo shoot here was to have the sun light up the background mountain here. It would do if we had a proper sunset, but we don't. And I think it would have looked really, really nice. It also works as a sunrise location where the other side of the mountain will be lit and probably also the background mountains. And I think that would all probably even look even better than a sunset. But that would be like 3:30 in the morning, so a bit hard to get to unless you're like really in it. And right now, according to the weather forecast, it's probably not going to happen. So I think we will just finish up here and get back home and get some sleep before tomorrow's endeavors. So we just walked a little bit further up and we found another small plateau here in the background where we can have a silhouette, and we have some foreground rocks over here and then the entire mountain. So it's really just about walking around trying to find something. Because it's so late and we're a little bit tired, I was just about to say, okay, the last shoot, that was fine, so head back down to the car. But we did manage to find this one here. So it's not about giving up, it's just like keep going and you might find something which is just a little bit better or at least different. We have already taken a few shots with Sophie down here, so now it's my turn to be a model.
And walking those extra 100 meters further up instead of calling it a day really turned out to be the right decision, as this was the perspective I ended up liking the most. It is also interesting that it was because of my vision of making this video I actually decided on ignoring my depressing mental state and going through with the hike. Normally making videos like this makes the entire process of photographing a fair bit harder. In this case, it was the driving factor of the video, which manifested in getting some photos. A few weeks later, I sat down to edit the pictures with a good strong beer from the local brewery and some melodic black metal. And black metal, I don't often listen to it, but in this case it really fitted the mood perfectly, and I needed to get back into that very moody and blue, rainy, depressing scene. So it actually turned out really, really well, and I got two of my favorite photos from 2018. I will talk more about these two photos in an upcoming video about my favorite photos from 2018. So for now, I would highly appreciate both a like and a comment. And yeah, until next time.